Hi everyone. So this is the next video, and in this video we are going to talk more about how we are associating one table into another table in the Sequelize. So we will also talk about how we can define the associations, and while fetching the data, what code we need to write so that we can get the data from one table to another table, because internally Sequelize is using joins to get the data, but we are not writing the joins in the SQL query. We are just writing the tags or the way which is provided by Sequelize to get the data from one table to another table, where there is a relationship already defined, there is a foreign key is already defined in the another table. Okay, so we have these three tables, feedback, recipes and cook. Cook has a recipe, recipe has a lot of feedbacks for that particular cook, so which we have defined something like this, right? Now the relationships. We know that we use hasOne and belongsTo to define one-to-one relationship in the Sequelize, and then there is a hasMany or many-to-many, all these kind of methods we use to define the relationships. And here we can also define the alias, like asCookReference and foreign key is cookID. Right, so what we are doing, we are actually getting we will be getting, while we are trying to get the data for recipe, we can write some code to get the cook information also for that particular recipe. And for that particular recipe, we can also get the comments from the feedback model. So let's go one by one on those particular routes. So recipe. So recipes, I mean, I'm trying to get all the recipes, and I will also try to get the cook for each and every recipe. So recipe.findAll include, here you can see, here you need to provide the model cook, which I wanted to populate, and reference is cook reference, because I have already defined reference here. So same reference you need to use as a cook reference. So for each and every recipe, it will try to look up onto the cook informations and it will populate that information. Second thing is, when you are populating the recipe, you also wanted to get the comments defined, comments added for that particular recipe. So recipe.findAll, and here model feedback and aliases comments, because we have defined aliases comments for the feedback model. We haven't defined the foreign key cook ID, that's fine, but we have defined the alias. Same alias we need to use while getting the feedback for particular recipe here. So this is how we are doing it. We can also see that in the code. So feedback, recipe and cook, these are the three models we have defined. And the mistakes which we were doing earlier, we were actually not passing the reference properly. I debugged that problem and I figured it out. So now I have created all these routes. Recipe. So recipe has relationship with the cook reference, and foreign key is cook ID. And recipe is also having relationship with one to many with the feedback, and reference is being used as a comments. So let's see that. So here you can see the first recipes. What it is doing, it is giving you all the recipes with the cook information. So let me just try to run this successfully. I'm able to do it. And here we will just say this, recipes. So you can see I'm getting only single recipe, and single recipe has a cook reference. Cook reference means whatever the alias we have created, now from that alias we are getting the data, right? So for that recipe, there is a cook reference. We are getting that reference. And cooks, it is giving you all the cook information. So if you see the route, cooks, what it is doing, it is just doing a simple cook.findAll. So it's a, like find one, find all, find by ID, find by foreign key, all these kind of simple methods. It is just giving us the cooks data. Now, how can I get the comments of a particular recipe or feedback of a recipe? So there is a method recipe out there. What it will do, currently I'm just, there is only single recipe. So I'm not doing a recipe, and I'm not passing any route parameter where I will do recipe.findbyid. I'm not doing that. I'm just, there is one recipe and I'm trying to populate the comments inside an array. So you can see here, I'm doing the same recipe.findAll or find one where id equal to that. You can do that, like if you wanted to do that, find one. And here you need to put where close, where id is one. That's it. Right, so here it will give you the that particular recipe where id equal to 1, and it will also include the data of comments for you. Okay, so this is how we can do that for now, find all. So you will get the data. Recipe information. So recipes will give you, I've just created some dummy routes. Don't look at how the routing is happening. Recipes is also giving you all the recipes. And recipe, you can also pass some dummy ID if you want, so that you don't feel that it's not a good practice. So recipe, and here you can just put find one. And what we can do is we can just put a where clause where ID is request.params.id. That is correct. And includes feedback as a comment, right? So this is how you can write a comment. So it will give you the individual recipe with the comments. And here we are trying to get all the recipes with the cook information, right? So it is just like you are getting all the recipes, and each and every recipe will have the cook information. But when I wanted to get a single recipe information, recipe by ID, then I can also, I can try this if this will work, that I can just provide another reference for the recipe. I wanted to get model cook and cook reference. Okay, so this is a homework. You can try it, and if this works, I will check it. Okay, thanks everyone.